Hello everyone and welcome to the Survivor Radio Network, your weekly nerd news. If you like this video, give us a like, consider subscribing, and join us on Discord. Everything we talk about this week will be linked below. Let's jump into it. Here are the new game releases this week. Amnesia Rebirth, a new story set in the world of Amnesia, The Dark Descent. This narrative horror experience is set to release on October 20th for PC and PS4. The Guise is a storybook-style, dark fantasy Metroidvania where you turn into a monster with weird abilities like walking on ceilings, acid spits, and bile bombs. October 20th on PC. Scourgebringer, this pixel art, hectic, roguelite platformer for Xbox One, Switch, and PC, as well as Xbox Game Pass, arrives on October 21st. Discroom, the year is 2089 and a giant disc has appeared in orbit of Jupiter. Step into the oversized spacesuit of a brave scientist and explore this sprawling intergalactic slaughterhouse. This top-down violent puzzle platformer spins to Switch and PC on October 22nd. Pokémon Sword and Shield, The Crown Tundra. This second expansion pass DLC for Pokémon Sword and Shield, the Arctic theme setting includes new and returning characters and Pokémon, Dynamax adventures, and Galarian Start Tournament mode, available on Nintendo Switch on October 22nd. The Red Lantern. This roguelite resource management narrative game where you and your team of five sled dogs, lost in the wilderness, must navigate the ever-changing events of the Alaskan bush to find your way home. And yes, you can pet the dog. The Red Lantern treks onto Xbox One, Switch, and the Epic Games Store on October 22nd. Transformers Battlegrounds. This tactical arcade turn-based strategy game featuring your favorite robots in disguise launches on PS4, Xbox One, Switch, and PC on October 23rd. Outer Worlds. The award-winning single-player space RPG from Obsidian Entertainment and Private Division finally hits Steam on October 23rd. If you haven't tried out this quirky RPG from the makers of Fallout New Vegas on console, Game Pass, or the Epic Games Store, you can now pick it up. With less than a month away from launch, we finally got our first look at the PS5 user interface and some of its features. The UI has been streamlined to remove barriers from the games and the settings that you frequently access. The Pause Resume menu for PS5 features game-specific cards including personalized level progress, media, game navigation, hints, and videos specific to the game and level you are currently playing. In addition, PlayStation parties have been revamped to include messages, voice chat, game invites, and media all in one place. It looks like PlayStation is trying to emulate the experience more like Discord on PC. Picture-in-picture mode is also available to watch your friends play while you still enjoy your own game. PS5 custom SSD allows everything to work quickly from menu navigation to resuming a game from standby to swapping to games on the fly. The UI has been designed with 4K in mind, and screen recording and image capture also support 4K resolution. There's still a lot more to learn about Xbox Series X and the PS5 before they launch on November 10th and 12th respectively, and we'll share all the news we get as we get it. In movie and TV news, Dexter made a surprise return announcement this week. Michael C. Hall and the original showrunner Clyde Phillips have returned for a limited 10-episode run. This beloved series about a crime scene investigator with homicidal tendencies has been off the air for almost 10 years. Given the mediocre reviews of the latter seasons, it's good to see the return, and it'll be interesting to see where they take the characters. The limited series is set to begin production early next year for a fall 2021 release. That's all for this week. Let us know what games you can't put down, what shows have you binge-watching them, and what's on your radar for the coming weeks. As always, you can join us in Discord with a link in the description. I'm Dragon, and this has been your SRN News for October 18th, 2020.